This game is tea and is not suitable for kids. Then over at my destination, the school gate, Fushibayashi is waiting. Up until now, she's always timidly stared at the ground. But today...
Okazaki-kun.
She greets me with a cheerful smile. It's like she's a different person. With dumbfounded expressions on their faces, the students who are leaving are all looking at Fushibayashi and me. Not paying the glances the slightest attention, Fushibayashi walks up to me and wraps her arm around mine. Wait, her arm? I feel the glares sharpen. Fushibayashi? Well, she's getting bold, isn't she? She says with a smile. Her face is red. Who is this girl? This isn't the Fushibayashi I know. Are they pulling the twin swap? Is it like, oh, Kyou cut her hair and put in blue contacts and it's and a voice changer? I hope that's what happens. Where are we going? Yeah, it kind of annoys me that they're both still referring to each other by their last name if they're dating. Well, I don't mind. Fushibayashi smiles and grabs my arm even tighter. Fushibayashi. It's touching. Your obob. If nothing else, Tsunahara at least gave me the euphemism obob for breast. Upon hearing what I said, her face immediately flushes deep red, and for a moment she lets go of my arm. However, she quickly grabs my arm again. Once again, I can feel the soft sensation of her breast pressing against me. Fushibayashi? Obobs. With tears building up in her eyes and her face flushing red, she looks at me. That's quite an amazing thing she just said. I really do wonder where we are going. Around us, people continue to give us strange looks. Fushibayashi continues to drag me along, even as slightly insolent thoughts run through my mind. Kyou did mention this before, but she really is surprisingly busty. With Fushibayashi's arm still clinging tightly to mine, we walk down the familiar road. In the meantime, Fushibayashi keeps talking to me tirelessly. Because I'm almost wondering... I mean, if this actually is Kyou, the reason for her to do this would be to basically be like, we gotta get rid of these rumors. And she's not gonna do it by going out with Tsunahara, so instead she's gonna pretend to be Ryou and do things a little more boldly than Ryou would do. Just so people will be like, they're dating? What? Again, crazy theory. But she's acting way bolder all of a sudden, kind of out of the blue. It seems strange. About class, about home, about what happened in the past, about now, and about where we will go from here. Hey, Fushibayashi?
Hi.
What's with you today?
え、何がですか?
You're acting kind of different than usual.
そうでしょうか?
How should I say this? Well, this may be rude to say, but you don't usually talk like that. And back at the classroom, what you said in front of everyone... Nah, that's not what I mean. It's just, I thought you've changed so suddenly. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Upon hearing that, Fushibayashi puts her finger on her mouth as if she's thinking something. Not at all. It's just... A bold side to you, eh? That makes you almost like Kyou. Just as I say that name out, my face grows pale. I immediately begin to regret saying her name as I feel something beating in the back of my throat. She's always watching. Why would I even bring up Kyou here? She's the one person that I shouldn't be comparing her with. Acting calm, I look beside me. Fujibayashi smiles, forcing my glance into a halt. She didn't mind that? I feel like the Ryou route has taken way longer, just because she like talks twice as slowly as any other character. No, I'm pretty sure Kyou said that, not Mike Tirano from GTA San Andreas. Yeah. Fujibayashi is smiling. That in itself isn't anything bad. But I wonder what this murky feeling inside me. In front of me, my smiling girlfriend is. Fujibayashi is overlapping with Kyou. Something runs down through my spine. I shudder. An uneasy feeling sinks into my body. Yeah, I feel like if this is Kyou, the one thing that doesn't make sense is how she's able to sound just like Ryou, because they have different voice actresses. Fujibayashi has brought me to a corner of the shopping district. It's the accessory shop that we went to on our date, the one that when Kyou tagged along. She has something to buy. Could it be...
いらっしゃいませ.
Oh yeah, because we still haven't given that to her.
タンザナイトですか? それでしたら...
I know they could just let Ryou... My point is, though, they sound different. Like, pretty starkly different. So I don't know how well Kyou would be able to just fake her sister's voice. The store clerk looks away from Fujibayashi for a second, lost in thought. Then, seeming to remember something, she looks at me. While Fujibayashi looks down in disappointment, the store clerk looks at me with a smile. Wait. Oh, this clerk. Could it be that she remembers me? Don't just say that out loud! Come on! Yeah, well, I haven't had the chance to, I guess. No, store clerk is the worst girl. well, how should I say this? Well, store clerk tries to hold back her chuckle while I flounder in my speech. Why would you say that? She went from being like, oh, what a bro, to being like, oh, really? She said that out loud? Well, that pendant, I was the one who bought it. Tilda's. I scratch my face. I can tell that heat is rising in her face. And I think I have it here. I say as I take out the box that has been laying in the corner of my bag. Store clerk, you're the worst! Why do we get to give it to her in the bad ending, but not the good one? Why? Well... Didn't you say before that you want this? Rail, talk faster! Well, yeah. Fujibayashi looks at me with watery eyes.
よかったですね.
Get out of here! She's smiling. Fujibayashi is smiling. She's looking at me with a smile. Yes! Okay, now, sorry. Please no with the F-bombs. Please and thank you. She's looking at me with a smile. There shouldn't be anything wrong with this. Nothing wrong at all. And yet, I wonder why something just feels off. Every time I look at her smile, a sense of guilt builds up inside me. That's stupid Clerk. She went from being like the best to the worst in literally the span of one sentence. nah, it's not a big deal at all. Stop it, Ryou! Do I have to wait like 5 seconds before to be like, is she actually done talking? Nope, she's still talking. Yeah, I guess there's that. I am leaving a 1-star Yelp review for that clerk. The place was great, pendant was great, worst clerk. 0 out of 10. That I don't have much of an excuse for. I bought it, sat on it, and only just gave it to you. Worried? Okay, I don't think this is Kyou disguised as Ryou anymore. This seems very much like Ryou. Your own fortune? Don't put any stock in this destiny, hogwash. Reverse death. So that means Jesus is gonna come into your life, right? Its name alone tells me how malevolent the card is. Reverse death is good. Actual death is bad. She says that, downplaying the results of her own fortune. Well, in your case, you don't ever get it right. Wow! Wow, you just said it! Holy cow, that was mean. Crap! By accident, I let slip something that I really should not have touched. I blame the clerk for that. We're in a bad mood because of the clerk. Given how much she loves fortune telling, this must come off as very harsh to her. Tildas. I feel pretty awkward. I steal a glance at her, moving only my eyes to the side. She seems to be acting normal? Perhaps she couldn't hear me. Well, how should I say this? Your fortunes are, well... Oh, she knows this? She knows that herself? Has she come to accept it? Okay, you're not making, like, any sense right now. That's unexpected. I would never have thought that she would answer me with a smile. Moreover, her views about fortune-telling is the most unexpected of all. How come... Don't fortunes only have meaning when they're right?
これからの未来に向けての道しるべの一つです。つまりそれって占いが当たってしまうと未来が一つしかないみたいじゃないですか。だから占いは外れてくれた方がいいんです。これから私たちが進む道にはたくさんの可能性があると思いたいんです。
You do realize, Ryou, that you're basically saying that it's best that fortune-telling doesn't exist, right? Like, you're literally saying it's best to not rely on fortune-telling or stuff to predict the future because we can make our own choices otherwise. Like, this is counter to your whole personality, basically. I'm honestly shocked. I never knew you could think like that when it comes to fortune-telling. I feel a little embarrassed for how naive I am, thinking that there's only right and wrong. Well, I mean, there is right in Rome. But, so what happens if you get a good fortune?
いいことですか?
Yeah. If you get the result that you want to come true, would you still think it's better if it's off?
はい。 もっといいことが起こるような未来になってほしいです。
Fujibayashi confidently senses this with a smile. To think she's so strong-willed. It makes me truly realize that she and Kyou are twins. They don't look alike, yet they are alike. Actually, it's kind of true. They have different faces. Like, they actually do. She's normally so timid and passive, but she does have a strong will of her own. It feels so dazzling. It makes me jealous. She's so strong-willed, it makes me even envious.
Okazaki-kun.
Hmm? Oh yeah, that's right.
それで明後日はその大級です。それでなんですけど、二人で遊びに行きませんか?
Am I gonna be spending the entire stream just on the real bad ending? It's feeling like that a little bit. Eh? Yeah, I don't think they are identical twins, because they have different eye colors. And different voices. She acts shyly with the red face that I've grown accustomed to. Yeah, I don't have anything planned, so I don't mind.
ありがとうございます。
She looks very happy, and bows with a smile. Watching her do that pains my heart. This is all because we didn't kiss her in the fortune-telling booth, apparently. We are dating. I'm going out with Fujibayashi. And yet, why do my actions, my words, why does everything feel like it carries so much weight? It is somewhat painful just looking at Fujibayashi's smile. Holy cow! She's actually calling us by her first name. Yes, sorry, Fujibaya. That little frown. Just that tiny little frown fills me with sadness. Ryou. Yes, finally, they're on the first name basis.
Ice cream.
One of your teachers mistook you and one of the twins as the twins? That's funny. Yeah, unidentical twins, they definitely exist. Ooh, ice cream! Thanks. I take the ice cream that Ryou is handing to me. We're in the courtyard. The sky is blue and the clouds are white. The burgers are... The burgers? The tree leaves waver and rustle in the breeze. Not that many people come here. Here I am, sitting on the stone fence of Ryou. She glances at me.
Mm-hmm.
She says bashfully. It makes me feel embarrassed as well. Gorsh! I can hear a lot of lively, cheerful voices from the school building. Today's the Founders Festival. It's a day that even third-year students take their mind off exams and relax. Hey, Fuji. Not the little frown! Ryou. Aww. Are there any classrooms you want to visit? The first and second years are doing all sorts of things, you know. Aww. I see. That really makes me feel embarrassed. Ryou is acting pretty bold today. It all began right after homeroom this morning. Having covered everything he needed to, the homeroom teacher leaves the classroom. At the same time, the classroom quickly becomes very lively. As a student, this is my last time participating in a Founders Festival. On top of that, we are a third year class and thus didn't need to hold our own class event this year. Everyone is excited.
Okazaki, omae dou suru?
What do you mean?
Boku wa kono mama ryou ni modotte neru tsumori da kedo.
Oh, no, bro. You don't... No, come on. Yeah, I guess we can do that.
Tomoya-kun.
Hmm?
Oya.
Ugh, sorry. Just got some water that went down the wrong pipe. Nah, something just fell off when you asked me. It's because she called us by our first name, at last. Which you should. Her face is colored red and her eyes are cast downward. They heard me shift toward the wall and then to me. Sunohara and I look at each other. It seems we didn't mishear. But she was still calling me by my last name just yesterday. Why the change all of a sudden? Nah, I don't really mind, it's just a bit sudden. No, you should be calling me by my first name. Is it super hot at my place? I mean, it's been pretty warm these last few days, to be sure. Today, it's in the 80s. It's not as hot as it was, like, a day or two ago. I think it was 2 days ago when it was, like, almost 90. Hey, I never complain about heat. I live in Michigan, and the winters are not fun. And I hate the cold, so I'm very happy for it to be this warm. Right after she said that, the classroom immediately goes silent. Everyone is looking at us. I hear several people murmuring. Oh, you don't measure in Fahrenheit? No, I was measuring in Celsius. It's 82 degrees Celsius. I'm not two-timing! Beat these guys up. They're all uttering such garbage. Yeah, I don't know the conversion from 90 degrees Fahrenheit to Celsius. She peeks at me. When she looks at me like that, what can I say? I don't mind being called that. In contrast to just now, a bright smile appears on her face. Her face is red, but she looks very happy. Yeah, Google does help. I'm streaming right now, though, so I'm not gonna Google stuff. Yeah? Yeah, it's weird if just one of you calls you by a first name. If I have to use an analogy, what would this be? Like I'm being forcibly plunged into a rosy aura? Or something like that? Who knew Ryou Fujibayashi would be so bold? She's getting character development. Oh, really? 90 degrees Fahrenheit is about 32 degrees Celsius. Okay, well, because... 32 degrees Fahrenheit is the freezing point. I just know that negative 40 is where the two meet up. Hey, wait! Wait, Fujibaya. She grabs me by my arm and starts dragging me to the door. I really do think that this is Kyou. I don't feel like Ryou would be this aggressive. Oh, you dislike anything above 68 degrees Fahrenheit? No. No, warm is good. for me. I don't think I've ever seen her do something so amusing. To think that Fujibayashi would take the initiative to do something other than fortune-telling. You're more of a winter person. Oh, not me. Like, I kind of want to move to Texas in a few years. Once we enter the hallway, we shut the door behind us. The classroom burst into a commotion. Get him under your tongue, goof. That's what I think it is. I actually think this is Kyou. Wow. That is rude, bro. And then... Twitch Automa's just like, hey, do you really want this person to type in chat the word undress? I'm like, yes, it's fine. I get the logic behind if you're cold, you can just put on more layers, but it doesn't hold. Because when it gets cold enough, especially when it's windy, my stupid headset keeps clicking. When it gets to a certain level of cold, especially if it's windy, it doesn't matter how many layers you have on. The cold just cuts right through it. Whereas for summer, it never really gets to the point where I'm like, I am so hot, can't bear it. And then, here we are now.
どうしました?
Nope, nothing.
もしかしてアイスクリーム...
Who doesn't like vanilla ice cream? I mean, sometimes it can be a bit bland, but come on. Eh? That's not really...
どうぞ.
Ryou says, and she holds out her slightly melted ice cream to me. Thanks. As instructed, I take a bite. The cold, sweet chocolate flavor spreads inside my mouth. I nod. Hmm? Okay. I hold out my vanilla ice cream to Ryou. Ryou stares at the ice cream, now right before her eyes, and then takes a quick glance at me. Then she sticks out her tiny tongue and licks the tip of the ice cream. Oh, I prefer chocolate to vanilla, but I mean, vanilla's pretty awesome. Oh, no, strawberry ice cream is awful. Don't put fruit in my ice cream, please and thank you. She says with a smile. She's so cute. Guess I got my money's worth. Nope, nothing at all. I do? Ryou says, and then she reaches her hand out toward with an innocent intent look. Slowly, slowly, her finger draws near my mouth. I can feel a light brushing sensation. Ryou says with a smile as she shows me the white melted whip of ice cream on her fingertip. In the very next moment, she puts it in her mouth. Okay, if she doesn't freak out because of this, then this is definitely Kyou. Without thinking, I blurt out, causing Ryou to look at me, confused. She tilts her head, her finger is still in her mouth. Okay, this is Ryou. Or this is Kyou. Well... Oh god, she put the ice cream that my lips had touched right into her mouth. That's pretty much an indirect kiss. But it wasn't that long ago that she ran away in tears just for putting the same pair of chopsticks in her mouth when we had lunch together. Yeah! That's what I'm saying. Well, since we've already kissed, I guess she wouldn't be all that shocked at an indirect kiss now. Have we kissed? We didn't kiss in the fortune-telling booth. Did I forget that we kissed after that? I don't think we did. As I've been staring at her mouth, she probably figured out what I was thinking. Ryou quickly opens her eyes. However, she's not at all panicked. Rather, she looks at me and smiles. Yeah. This really befuddles me. The Ryou that I know isn't someone who would say something like this. Yeah, this is Kyou. But then she hasn't changed that much either. Hmm? I didn't notice Ryou staring at me while I was spacing out. Is something still on my face? I ask as I wipe my mouth with my fingers. While she keeps peeking at my face,
kiss したら甘いか?
She asks me with a blushing face. She then glances around. Wait, if she's looking around, does that mean...
Tomoya-kun.
She lifts her chin up and pulls herself toward me. Here?
Minna kousha no hou de omatsuri ni machuu desu kara.
But somebody might see us, you know?
Daijoubu desu yo.
Wow. We actually are getting this CG again. But her body gets even closer. I can't take my eyes off of her lips. Crap, I can't get away. Although my head is telling me this is not a good idea, it feels like another part of me is expecting, yearning even for it at some point, at the same time.
Tomoya-kun.
Her eyes are closed. Alright, well, we have our thumbnail for the video. You don't think this is Kyou? Okay, then Ryou got, like, significantly bolder in the span of 24 hours. You don't think she could? Yeah, it's a toss-up. Her eyes are closed. It's no good. I can't resist that. Perhaps it's instinct, or maybe it's because of my own desire. I close my eyes and draw my lips toward Ryou's. I can feel something soft touching me. At first it feels cold, but it gradually turns into warmth instead. I know she obviously has feelings for Tomoya. Both of them do. But, like, literally just a few days ago, Ryou, like, yeah, she literally just used chopsticks that were in our mouth and freaked out and ran out because she was so embarrassed. And now she's, like, basically licking stuff off of our face and being like, haha, this is cute. The kiss has the aroma and taste of chocolate to it. I can faintly hear her breathing through her nose. At the same time, I can feel my heart pounding furiously. The kiss is so fervent, it turns my mind into a blank, to the point that I almost forgot where I was. Because it feels like Ryou is doing this specifically in front of other people, being like, I think we should let everyone know we're dating, and that seems like something Kyou would want, so that the rumors go away. With our lips still overlapping, I slowly open my eyes. Ryou's face cannot get any closer to me than it is now. Well, of course, after all, we're kissing. You can't get any closer than that, Russell. Hmm? Eh? I glance away from Ryou, toward a spot and not very far behind her. The moment I look there, my eyes feel as if they were going to burst. There's a single student in her uniform looking this way. Although I have seen her face for many times now, this is the first time I've ever seen such an expression. Her eyes are wide open and her body is frozen. And she looks like she might break out in tears any second. It's Kyou. Oh no, we get the really sad piano music now. She turns around and dashes away. I thought that was Kyou who we were kissing. Marty is my sister, by the way, Mirko. Marty has taken some Japanese classes. And she has seen the anime. So she was like, oh, you're playing CLANNAD, awesome! And she kind of wanted to see what the visual novel was like compared to the anime. She isn't able to make it to these streams very often anymore because she has a busy life. At almost exactly the same time, Ryou's lips twitch. She slowly pulls her head back. Okay, I'm sorry, I thought you were Kyou. Her face then turns red. VN is better if you ask me. I mean, I generally don't like anime, but I like VNs. From what I've heard, basically, is, like, season one of the anime is pretty good, and season two, which has, like, the after-story stuff, is, like, amazing. And also, like, will rip your heart out and put it through a meat processor. Yeah, sorry. This track really gets to me. This is, like, one of the saddest piano pieces I've heard. What VNs have I got planned so far after this one? The only one that I really have planned is The Fruit of Grisea. Which is gonna be a lot darker than this one, from what I've heard, but I've heard it's, like, really, really good. This track is called Roaring Tides 2. Oof. This is what played during the Tomoyo good ending, which really felt like a bad ending, so it hit me hard. Another thing that I do is I don't stream this, but my sister Marty and I have recorded the Ace Attorney, are recording the Ace Attorney series. First two games are up on YouTube. We're recording the sixth one right now, and I have a 3, 4, and 5 on backlog. So I'll be uploading those to YouTube in the future as well. You recommend Island? Yeah, you talked about that one. It sounds interesting. Took you 66 hours to complete 100%. Wow, that's a commitment. Not really. Taking care not to alert Ryou, I glance in the direction Kyou had ran off. She can no longer be seen. There's nobody here. I can say nothing, except that.
そうですか.
Ryou smiles.
キス。やっぱり甘かったですね.
She simply looks at me happily and innocently. Oh. This does suck, because... This more sucks just because it seems like, for some reason, Tomio's now just, like, no longer into Ryou all that much. In the end, we hardly visited any of the exhibits at the festival. All we did was stay together the entire time. We just hugged each other, leaned against each other, and kissed each other. We kissed one last time when we left each other, and by then I had already forgotten how many times we've kissed today. What came as a relief, I suppose, is that Kyou has not showed up since. Tomorrow, I have a date with Ryou.